Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Mike at HiFiInsider.com. Today, I have a unique video to share with you. We're going to look at the evolution of Apple earphones. We're going to start at the end there in 2001, all the way up to 2016, the current AirPods. So without further ado, let's take a look. So in 2001, Apple introduced the iPod to the world, and this was actually a game changer because it really put Apple back on the map as a relevant electronics company. The original iPod came with these little earbuds, which are nowadays they are actually quite rare, especially in good condition. These little earbuds, as you can see here, the design is very different from the ones that we are now used to. These little earbuds does not have a remote control on the end, and it has it's a two-pole connector, and it's a pretty decent sounding earbud when used with a high-end music player, and I think that the sound is actually quite flat. But they got a bad rep because the iPod did not have good sound quality, in my opinion. The iPod, its software was actually limiting the iPod's performance, and it only supported 128 kilobytes of audio files. Anything higher, it will play it, but it doesn't play it smoothly, meaning that it would actually have a little hiccup here and there because of the memory in the hardware does not have enough storage to buffer that memory. So with a low quality bitrate MP3 file, 128, that was not an issue. But with anything higher than that, the memory was not able to store enough for it to be for it to not skip or pause while it's playing music. So that's what we had back in 2001. Now this here is very rare these days. This was released in 2004. These are the iPod premium earphones. People complain about the sound quality of the original of the earbuds that came with the iPod. So Apple released these premium earbuds for their line of iPods. Now these sold for $39, and this is the case that it came in, and it's actually very nicely made. You have the small ear tips and the large ear tips on the side, and then you have the medium ear tips installed on the earbuds. So I'm going to show you what the earbuds look like first. I'm actually not going to get them out of the case because they were actually quite difficult to get back into the case neatly. So let me show you the earbuds. They weren't very successful. Not many of these were actually sold, and so this is actually hard to find these days. And because they didn't fit people very well, the shape of this didn't seal very well, and they end up sounding bad. But if you do have a good seal, they actually sound pretty decent. They're pretty flat as well. So it's a pretty clever design, as you can see here. There's a little notch here, so you can line up the ear tip with the notch so you know that you have the correct orientation of the ear tip. So let me just give you guys a close-up look at these. So they don't have a remote control, and it's got a two-pole jack just like the earphones that the iPod came with. Now it takes us to 2007. The original iPhone came out. Steve Jobs released this. And this really changed the world. This is really a computer in your pocket. Of course, it had the iPod music player. Sadly, Apple has discontinued support for this. So the software, I'm not able to transfer any music to it anymore. Even using an old iTunes 8, I'm still not able to transfer music to this. It still makes phone calls though, but it doesn't work as a music player, sadly. It worked up to until last year, 2017. 2018, Apple did something and it no longer works, sadly. So because of the new iPhone, Apple needed to revise the earphones that came in the box. So these earphones are probably the ones that we've seen a lot around the street and everywhere. Now the iPhone needed a way to answer calls. So Apple built in an inline microphone and remote control. So this remote control can only answer calls. It's only got one click. It cannot change the volume control. And these little earbuds, they were pretty bad sounding. I think it's really because they leak a lot, so people around you can hear what you're listening to. But in a quiet environment, they are actually okay. I thought that the original earphones that Apple included with the iPod was actually better. But overall, you know, these are free in the box. So this is a three-pole connector, straight jack, of course. Apple released the iPod Touch. This is the first generation iPod Touch. Sadly, I forgot to charge this before I made this video. So it needs to be charged. So anyhow, this is the iPod Touch, 32 gigabyte here, which is the top of line model. Interestingly, the iPod Touch does not have any volume controls on the device itself. It only has the on-off button and the home button. So, again, Apple needed to ship a pair of earphones with it. They made a version of the iPhone earbuds, exactly the same as the iPhone one, but without the remote control. So this is a two-pole because it doesn't have a remote control, it doesn't have an inline microphone. But these are the same earbuds that were shipped with the iPhone, the original iPhone, and with all the iPods that Apple make. Apple released the iPod Nano. Steve Jobs announced the premium in-ear headphones. So the iPod Nano, which was really cool because now the iPod earphones, which is the same earphones as the previous generation, now includes an inline microphone, a remote control with volume up and down. And Steve Jobs talked about this in the keynote, so that you can adjust the volume without pulling the iPod out of your pocket. This is a three-pole. Now the jack also updated. Because of the rubber coating on the jack, it got really nasty with a lot of the earbuds that were out there. So they changed to a plastic jack here. So it is actually a firm plastic, so it doesn't get nasty. It has a better strain relief as well. Oftentimes, the jack here, when people stick it in their pocket, it cracks right here at the joint here, and where the earphone can fail. So these little in-ears, let me show you the box first actually. They still sell this, and they're actually okay. They're not too bad. Very flat sounding, doesn't really have much bass to them, even with a good seal. So, and it came with this little case here. This case, it's pretty, but it's not effective. very difficult to get the earphones into the case. So it's no one in the right mind will use this case on a daily basis. So these little hi-fi in-ear headphones are much smaller than the original in-ear headphones, and they've improved upon the tips. Now the tips here with the first batch of these, they were actually too loose, so people kept losing these tips. So they keep either getting stuck in your ear or they fall out. So later on, Apple revised it and made the tips a little bit more secure. And then the screen that protects the driver can also be removed. So in case of a wax buildup, the wax can easily build up in here because of how close they are with the tips. They actually came with extra screens, two of them. So in case yours really got, really nasty, you can simply just replace it. They came in the box. The different ear tips, the little holder that it has, it's actually quite clever as well. And so when you open it up, there's your ear tips. So you got the S for small, and then large, L for large. Again, people actually don't use it very much because these little caps fall out very easily. So these earphones has an updated 3-button remote control, as you can see here. It's much nicer, better strain relief. It's got an integrated microphone as well, just to show you a comparison. So now we're gonna move to 2016. Apple decided to get rid of the headphone jack. So the iPhone, it's called the iPhone 7, they decided to say, forget it, we don't want the headphone jack anymore. And because they call it courage or something like that, to remove a legacy technology port. So they had to ship you a new pair of earphones that is actually quite improved from the original ones. These are the new AirPod earphones. And as you can see here, certainly very nice design. And they had to ship you one with a lightning connector with the phone. Now they do make a version previous to 2016 that are like this with a 3.5 millimeter jack. I actually forgot to put that in this video. And of course it's got the upgraded inline remote control as well, just like the premium in-ear headphones. These are okay. They are improved in sound quality, but nothing to really write home about. At the same time, 2016, Apple is moving their products towards wireless. So they release, to me, their best earphone is the AirPods. These are completely wireless, and it has Apple's new Bluetooth chip. It's called a W1 chip. These AirPods sells for $159 in the US, and they are very, very clever. They got this little pill case. Some people call it dental floss. And they are completely wireless. They have an integrated microphone. It has a proximity sensor. So when you put it in your ear, it automatically detects that. It's a vibration sensor here on the stem. So when you tap on it, you can engage different features like play, pause, forward or backward in the music, and also engage Siri. So really, really advanced technology in such a small package. And the battery life is actually pretty good. And they sync via your iCloud account. So once you pair this to one device, it is paired to all of your devices via iCloud once you're signed into it. They also included a Find My AirPods feature. So if you lose them, you can go to find your iPhone and your AirPods will appear. And also it has a feature where you can send a signal to the AirPods to make it ring really loud, so annoying sound, so you can find them. So a lot of technology in these little AirPods for $159, and the sound quality of these are actually the best of all of the Apple earphones. Great bass, especially when you're in a quiet environment. They don't isolate very well because you don't want to walk around the street and not be able to hear your environment. This is similar to Apple's, you know, thoughts in earphones. They want you to hear your environment so you don't get hit by a car or something. But in a quiet environment, they sound really, really good. Okay, everyone, this is it. So we walk back from 2001 all the way up to 2016. If you like this video, let me know in the comments. If you'd like to see more, let me know what you'd like to see. I have an Amazon store if you want to see what I've purchased and I enjoy and I recommend to my friends. Check out my Amazon store link in the description. And I'll see you guys again in my next video. Bye-bye.